Welcome to Cabbage. After a long time, we come to you with a new content. We are working on Nodejs. Today, I will show you how to add login with Google in my Nodejs project. Here, I will use GraphQL. You can use also REST API. The controller function will be the same. Please see the full video for better understanding. Let's start the video. Here you can see in my code editor, I already create two projects, server and client. Here in server side, I create a GraphQL Express server. I already create a video how to create GraphQL Express server. If you do not see the video, I will give the link in my descriptions. Here you can see I use Apollo Server Express and GraphQL for creating the server. In the client side, I use Nextjs. I already create an index page component with Google login. Here I will place login with Google button. I already create an environment file. Here I will put all the API key and secret key. I hope you are familiar with Nextjs. If you are familiar with ReactJS only, then you can go through with ReactJS. Here you can see I already opened two terminals. One for server side and another for client side. Let's test our project. First of all, run my client project. npm run dev, go to the browser and go to the localhost with port 3000. Here we can see Google login text. Here it's running successfully. Let's go ahead. Here actually I want to put a login with Google button. For this we can use one package. We can search for React Google login. Here first one. Just go ahead. It is a popular package. You can see the weak download number is big also. Actually, I am using this package for login with Google button. They provide a Google login component with customization frogs. You can go through all the documentation here. Here you can find all the things you want or need. Here just copy install code. Close the server. Here I can paste it. Start the installation process. We can see the installation is starting. It is completed. Now actually we need Google API key. In your browser, just search for Google Developer Console. Go to the Google Developer Console website. Click here and create a new project. Give the project name. You can give any name. Google Login. And click on Create button. Here we can see the project is creating. Just click here and select our project. Now project is selected. Now under APIs and services, click on credential. Click on create credential, then click OAuth client ID here. Then click on configure consent screen. Click on create. Here you have to give application name. I type login with Google. Give user support email. Go down and give developer email address. You can give any email address here. Recheck everything is okay. And then click on save and continue. Oops, we can see one error occurred. Okay, I can understand. I think we have to give different application name and try again. Just change something in application name. Go down and click again on save button. Success. Here actually nothing we have to change. We can go ahead. Click on save and continue. And again click on save and continue. Success. Now click on go to the dashboard button. It is now testing mode. We can publish it either or we can go credential phase again. Here click create credential again. Click on OAuth client ID. Here we have to give our application type. Here we are building a web application. That's why we select web application. Name of that application. Here we can give any new name. Login with Google Nodejs. Here add authorized JavaScript origins. Click on add URL. Give our localhost URL with port 3000. Give as well authorized redirect URLs also. And also give the localhost URL with port 3001. After giving the all URL, just click on create button. Here we can see client ID and client secret. Just copy both API and paste it to our environment. First of all, copy the client ID. Go to the VS Code. Here in environment, change the env name to Google client ID. and fetched the client ID. Create one new env name with Google secret ID. Copy the secret ID and paste it here. Now we can start our server, npm run dev. Refresh the browser. Okay, now add login button. First of all, import Google login from React Google login. Here we can copy it. Now copy the component, paste it in here. Here we can keep it, it also, and it can be removed. In the client ID, we have to give our client ID. Type process.env, the env name. Now we can add onSuccess and onFailure function. Here you can see it in the function for onFailure or onSuccess. Just copy it and paste it in here. Go to the browser. Here we can see the Google login button appear. Here is one problem. We can just wrap the whole component to a div. Now it looks good. We can change our button text also. Login with Google. It looks more good. You can see when I click the button, it opens a pop-up window for Google access. Now we can select any account. Now it successfully logged in. If we see the console in browser, we can see the token ID also. We actually need this token ID for gathering all info for user. We successfully done in our client part. Now we can start working on server side. First of all, we have to define our types. Go to the type tabs and user types. Here we have to define type for Google authentication. We can write one mutation type, write extend type mutation. Here create one mutation with Google auth, input will auth input, and return state will success info. Let's define auth input as input. Auth input, here we only accept ID token from client. Here define success info, type success info, message will string, success will boolean. We successfully define our type definition. Now we can create resolver or controller function. Now go to the resolver and user resolver. Here we have to write our Google auth resolver, mutation, curly braces. Type the resolver name Google auth, async first argument will none. From the second argument we collect the input. Now we can test with console log input. Our resolver works perfectly. Let's start our server first. Go to the browser and go to localhost 3001/graphql. Okay, here we can see something is going wrong in our backend. We can see cannot extend type mutation. I think we forget to extend our mutation type. Just go to the index under main folder. Yes, here we can see we forget to extend mutation type. Type mutation underscore string. Now server is running successfully. Go to the browser and refresh the page. Click on query your server. Here we can see the Apple Studio playground. Here we can create one mutation query, mutation, Google auth, query name again, type return state, message, and success. Here we have to send input field, input will be ID token. Give one curly missing here, you can now format document. Place the request, here we can see request placed successfully. In the terminal we can see we receive ID token field also. Now go to the resolver, remove the console, and here type our controller function. First of all, we need one package. Search Google auth library in our browser. I use this official Nodejs client for Google auth. Just install it. Okay, it installed successfully. Now start the server again. Import it, const curly, require Google auth library. OAuth to client, const client new OAuth to client. Here actually we need to put Google OAuth client ID that we grave from Google developer console. We can copy it from client environment to our server environment and we can rename it. Okay, here type process.env.google client ID. Now we can create a Mongoose model. Actually, here we are using MongoDB for storing user data. Under the model folder, create one new file named user model. Const curly require mongoose schema and model. Module.exports.user model user schema timestamps will be true for creating timing index. Here field will be name string, email string, avatar string, provider string, provider ID also will be string. Now go to the user resolver again. Here import our user model. Const user require ./ model / user model. Write the controller function. Const client ID will be this Google ID. Const curly braces await client.verify ID token. ID token will be ID token we are getting input field from front end. Here we can change in our type depths. We can remove it from here. We can type here ID token will be string. And in the resolver, now we can get ID token directly from client. And here also give ID token. In the second parameter, we have to give audience. Audience will be client ID. Here we receive the payload from the return statement. And here it will be inside in curly braces also. Now we can cancel our payload. Go to the playground and place one request with ID token. ID token we are getting from client side. Place the request. In the terminal, we can see the user info. Here we find all the things we need like ISS, sub, ID, email, name, and avatar, all the things. We have to save it in our database. Right, if payload have a email verified field, then const user await user.findOne email as basis email. If we have not user, then we have to create new user. Const new user field will be name, payload.name, email, payload.email, avatar, payload.picture, provider, payload.iss, provider ID will be payload.serve, await new user.save. Return message will be login successful, success true. Else we have a user already, then just return the success message. And else email is not verified email, then return the error message login unsuccessful, success will be false. Ops here will be payload.email. Okay, now request again. We can see the login successful message. Success is true also. If we go to the Mongo Compass, here we can see user stored in database successfully. Now we have to integrate this API in client. Go to the client and index. Here we have to write function. First of all, import axios from axios. If you are not installed it, you can install it also. Okay, write function axios.post. Here we need to give API endpoints link. Dot then for getting response. If there is no error in response, then we have to store or show success message. Create a use state. Const message set message react.use state default will be string. Set message res.data dot data dot message. Here also be data. Now we have to show message. Just show the message here. Now we have to pass our query in the second argument. Type query backtick, copy our mutation query and paste it in here. Here ID token will be a dynamic portion. Response.token ID. And here it will be one step more with Google Auth. Success. We can delete it for testing, refresh it and login again. Here we can see login successful message also. In the compass we can see also user stored in database. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon to never miss our new idea.